No, let us solve this problem. Ask in gate 1999. It says that a 4-pole lap-wound DC generator has a developed power of P watt. Developed power of P watt. Right here, P watt. This is the power developed by a 4-pole lap-wound DC generator. And voltage of E volt. E volt. Two adjacent brushes of the machine are removed as they are worn out. So two brushes have been removed. If the machine operates with the remaining brushes, remaining two brushes, right? For 4-pole lap wound, we have four brushes. So remaining brushes will be two. The developed voltage and power that can be obtained from the machine. So the same developed power and EMF has been asked. These are the earlier one when all the four brushes were working. Now two brushes have been removed. So come to the diagram which we drawn for 4-pole lap wound itself. So we can use the same diagram which we discussed in our previous lectures, how to draw this, right? So if all the brushes are working, so current distribution in various coil sides and armature terminals are like this. So these are the terminals, two terminals, output terminals, let us say A and B. And let us represent this E. So developed voltage will be, these are the developed quantities, voltage and power. This is terminal voltage E. And power is nothing but E times IA. E times IA, developed power. So in DC, the product of developed voltage and armature current will give you the developed power E into IA in earlier case. Suppose if any one brush, let us take the case for one brush, then we will come to the two brushes. If any one brush is removed, suppose this brush is removed. So the current from these two coils can't be collected, as we discussed that the current collected by a particular brush can't be collected by the other brush, right? So these two currents can't be collected. So this time this current will not flow. In this case, what was current in this? Ia by 4, here also Ia by 4. So these two can be collected. The current in a particular coil can only be connected if the brushes are there at the two ends. So here this can be collected, here also three brushes are there. So the total current here will be, now this will become Ia by 2 and this will be Ia by 4. So total Ia by 2 will flow and this Ia by 2 will be there, right? This Ia by 2 will go there and leave like this. So Ia by 4 here and Ia by 4 through this. Fine. Now come to our case. It says that two adjacent brushes. So remove any two brushes adjacent, this one and this one. Now this brush has also been removed in the problem. So in this case, this current can't be collected. So only this coil is having brushes at its two ends. So this current can be collected. This will be Ia by 4. So this, in this case, now this will be Ia by 4. And this will be Ia by 4. And this will be Ia by 4. And this will be Ia by 4. So the situation will be like this. So in present case, when two consecutive brushes are removed, any two brushes, only coil connected between two brushes will carry a current of Ia by 4, which can be collected by the with the help of these two brushes, and that can be sent to the armature terminals and to the load. So in this case also, what about EMF induced? So the whatever the EMF earlier was there, The same will be there. Parallel connected arms will have same EMF. So though out of four parallel connected coils, three are gone. So even though one will have the same EMF as the other three connect parallel connected terminals. So the E will be same, the new, let us represent E dash. So E dash will be same as earlier one. But what about power? So let us represent P dash. So P dash will be equal to E dash time IA dash. So this time E dash remains same. And what about IA dash? So earlier armature current was IA, now it has been reduced to IA by 4. So you may write IA by 4. So that means EIA by 4. So we may write EIA is P, developed power in previous case upon 4. So in this case, the developed power will be reduced to 25%. So in this case, I think this option is correct. Let us solve one more problem. This problem was asked in GATE 2015, set 2. It says that a 4-pole separately excited wave wound DC machine with negligible armature resistance is rated for 230 volt and 5 kilowatt. The voltage and power ratings, terminal voltage and power rating of the machine are given by this 230 volt and 5 kilowatt at a speed of 1200 rpm. Rated speed is given. If the same armature coils are reconnected, so earlier armature coils were connected to form wave wound, now the same coils are reconnected to form a lap winding. What is the rated voltage in volts and power in kilowatt? So the two ratings, rated voltage and power in case of wave wound, were this. Now in case of lap winding, we have to find out the same ratings, voltage and power in kilowatt respectively at same rated speed. A speed has not been changed of the reconnected machine if the field of circuit is left unchanged. So the speed is not changed and the field excitation is not changed. Means phi is as it is, flux per pole is as it is, and n speed is as it is. So let us make the two cases. Earlier case, wave wound, and the latter case, lap. So we know that in wave wound machine, the number of parallel paths are 2, irrespective of the number of poles. Whereas, in case of lap winding, the number of parallel paths depends on the number of poles. So for case of 4-pole machine, in case of lap winding, the number of parallel paths will be 4. Fine. And let us take load is here. So load will be supplied with these terminals. So here, whether you are showing brushes or not, doesn't matter. So load will be there. So the terminal voltage, let us take this voltage by V. And EMF induced will be represented by E. So what is difference between these two? We know that EMF induced is equal to V plus IA RA. But here, negligible armature resistance. So armature resistance has been ignored. So here, V will be equal to E. Fine. So in case one, what is terminal voltage? That is 230 volt. So this is 230 volt. We are talking for waveform case. Let us draw one boundary here. So this is 230 volt, and we know that E is nothing but phi PNZ upon 60A. So in case of waveform, this A is equal to 2. So directly write here into 2. Fine. So mark this as, or you may mark V is equal to 230 volt is equal to 5PNZ upon 60 into 2. Let us take equation number 1. Now, power rating P is 5 kilowatt. In case of wave wound machine, this is 5 kilowatt. And we know that power is nothing but if current is I, or in terms of resistance, so we may write P is equal to V square upon R. R equivalent, basically R equivalent. So let us take the total number of conductors in the machine as Z. Z is here, the Z is total number of conductors. So nearly half of the conductors will be in this path, and half of the conductors will be nearly, we are not talking about dummy coils and like that. So nearly half of the total conductors will lie here, half of the total conductor will lie here. If you are going to distribute the same number of conductors in four parallel paths, then you can see that this will be Z by 4. So here, whatever EMF induced will be there in Z by 4 conductors, twice of that will be induced here in Z by 2 conductors. So let us take Z is number of conductors. So number of series connected conductors increases, the EMF induced also increases. So let us take the resistance of Z by 2 conductor as R by 2. So let us this R equivalent, write here R equivalent. So you may write, let us take the resistance of Z by 2 series connected conductors as R by 2. So for Z by 2, if resistance is R by 2, so for Z by 4 series connected conductors, this will be R by 4. It means, if we are going to assume the resistance of Z by 2 series connected conductors as R by 2, so the resistance of half of the number of conductors connected in series will be half of this, that is R by 4. Fine. So what will be equivalent resistance? So this will be R by 2, this will be R by 2, so equivalent will be R by 4. So you may write this will be equal to V square upon R by 4. Fine. This will be equal to 4 V square upon R. Let us take this as 2, where P is given by, the value is given. In this case, let us take again V. So V will be equal to E minus IaRa, and Ra is ignored, so this will be equal to E, this will be equal to 5PNZ upon 60 into A. So A, number of parallel paths, so A is equal to P for lap winding, so P is 4 poles, so directly put here 4. So let us represent this as dash. For this case, lab case, we are going to represent with dash, because here we have represented V V itself, V wave, or you may write VW, PW. So VL, let us represent L, EL. So EL will be this. So we have E, VL as this, and we have VW as this. VW is given as this. So we may write, this implies VW by VL in case of lap winding, the voltage ratings will be equal to, VW is 5PNZ upon 60 into 2 this whole upon 5PNZ upon 60 into 4. So this is coming out to be, this implies VW by VL, this is coming out to be 2. So this implies, see, all will get cancelled, or this will come up, so 4 by 2, 2. So this implies, in case voltage rating in case of lap winding, lap wound machine, VL will be equal to VW by 2, and this is VW is 230 volt by 2, that is 115 volt. So from options you may look, so out of these two anyone is correct. This is coming out to be the voltage rating in case of lap wound, right? So come to the next one. So let us take the power rating in this case as P dash. So P dash will be equal to V dash square by R dash equivalent. Let us represent the equivalent resistance by R dash. What will be R equivalent? So if resistance of Z by 2 is R by 2, so resistance of Z by 4 conductors connected in series will be R by 4, R by 4, R by 4, this will be R by 8, again R by 4, R by 4, R by 8 equivalent, R by 8, R by 8 equivalent will be R by 16. So you may mark somewhere R dash equivalent is equal to R by 16. And V dash is equal to VW by 2, just we calculated, right? So we may write VW by 2 square upon R dash equivalent will be equal to R by 16. So this may be written as VW square by 4 into 16 by R. Fine. So VW, okay, this is VW basically. VW. So 4VW square by R. So we may write, this implies multiply with 4 up and down. So we can multiply 4 up and down both to get 4VW square, this 4VW square by R. So this 4VW square by R, not this 4 basically, will give you, okay, R will be included. So 4VW square by R, this 4 will get cancelled with this one, and this is coming out to be 4VW square by R. This is same as that of PW. So not dash, basically you may PL in case of lap winding. So power rating is not going to be changed. Power rating remains the same, whether lap or wave winding. So earlier power rating was 5 kilowatt, next it will be 5 kilowatt. So option B is the correct option. So voltage has been reduced to half and this has been remain unchanged. Power rating remain unchanged. Why? See, the voltage rating is more in case of wave winding if number of poles are not equal. as more and more series connected conductors are there, so net EMF becomes more than in case of having parallel path more than 2 in lap winding. At the same time, the equivalent resistance is reduced. If number of parallel arms increases, so equivalent resistance decreases, and with this decrease, the power rating V square by R remains the same. As V is halved, then R is also reduced in the same proportion to take care of a square term, right? Or in other words, we can say that in lap wound, we discussed that the total current contribution from all the parallel connected coils are contributed to the armature current. So armature current is more in case of lap winding, whereas in case of wave winding, armature current is less. On the other hand, voltage rating is more in case of wave winding and voltage rating is less in case of lap winding. So these two, I and E, both gives the unit of power. So power remains unchanged in both the cases. Fine.